So today we're going to open up a couple of cans of spray paint so that we know exactly what it looks like inside and the mechanics so that we're better able to understand how to unclog it when we run into that situation. Let's go. At the table, and I had a lot of fun actually cutting open the cans. We actually lost one, so you know, rest in peace to that one. Let's say our respects, and now we're back. So when we look into the cans, what we're gonna see is basically the nozzle going from the top of the can right here, the opening, all the way down to the bottom of the can right there. It's the same for this can as well. So these are two different types of can. These spray paint cans I use for artwork. This one you can find at Home Depot. You use it more for like household purposes, but they're both made pretty much the same way. The nozzle will go from the top. This one is actually a female one. This one is more of a male sort of cap opening. So basically they're gonna use different caps on these sort of spray paint cans. So in the can, there's going to be basically a mixture of paint and propellant. Propellant, most likely gas based on the brand. The propellant is compressed. It's at the top, the paint is at the bottom, but it's because it's compressed, it's actually pushing down on the paint. And because the nozzle is at the bottom, the propellant actually forces the paint to sort of go in the nozzle when you're sort of pressing down on that cap and opening up the valve up here. The propellant is pushing that paint down there into the valve, and that is sort of that action that is happening. Because of that, one great way of cleaning the cans or cleaning the caps in the nozzle is actually turning the can upside down and spraying, mainly because when you turn the can upside down, the paint goes down here, the propellant is at the top, but the nozzle is still at the top. So when you're spraying, you're actually spraying that propellant. When you're spraying the propellant, you're basically clearing out that nozzle and you're cleaning the cap as well. So that's like one great way of actually cleaning your spray paint can. So do that every time you finish it, and even at the beginning when you first buy it. Another thing that we see in the spray paint cans are the mixing balls. So when we're shaking it up, you hear that rattle right there. It's basically going to be these balls. So this brand right here, Cobra, these two are Cobra. They have the two mixing balls right here. And this one right here is the enamel from the Rust-Oleum brand. Basically, it's just one large mixing ball, but that is going to be the ball that basically breaks up that sort of paint that sits at the bottom. So the balls serve a huge purpose when it comes to spray paint, mainly because the paint sits at the bottom. It can sit there for a long time. So when you break it back out and you want to spray something, you want to make sure you shake it up really good. That way these balls are breaking up all that sediment, all that paint that's been there, that's been sitting there for maybe days, weeks, months, could be a couple of years. I've had cans in my sort of stockpile for years. Not the best thing to do, but you know, I shake it up really well. So now that you know the mechanics and how it looks inside, you're better able to visualize the troubleshooting process whenever you encounter a clog. So when you encounter a clog, what you want to do first is just stop. You don't want to exacerbate the problem because you don't know what it is or where it's starting or where it's ending in terms of the clog. So you just want to stop. So step number one in figuring out how to unclog the can, if you run into a clog, is basically figure out whether it's the cap or the can. A lot of these cans usually come with a universal cap, standard cap. The opening is not too small, it's not too large, it's like right in the middle. And sometimes because they've been sitting on the shelf for a long time, you wanna make sure it's not that universal cap that you put on there. So really you just wanna take off the cap and actually put on a cap that has a wider opening, like a fat cap or this calligraphy cap right here, and actually just spray. And if it sprays, that means it's not the actual can, it's most likely the nozzle or the cap. And basically, what you can do to clean the cap, if you want to save that cap, you can use compressed air to put it at one end, the opening, and shoot that sediment right back out the other way. You can also soak the cap in sort of a solution as well, a cleaning solution to sort of break it up or to soften up the cap, and take a needle and just dig out that sort of sediment. But because these caps are sort of affordable, I usually sort of just throw the cap away because I don't want that cap sort of clogging up or messing up another can. You know, if it still doesn't work, that means it's probably not the cap, it's the nozzle inside. And as we have seen, the nozzle inside is very narrow. And we also know that paint sits at the bottom. And if you didn't shake it up really well, probably there's sort of chunks in there that have gotten into the nozzle. So you can try a fatter cap. If you can get a bigger one to sort of unclog it as much as you can. You can even take a sort of a needle or something thin and just sort of hit in there to sort of open up that valve to see if you can just shoot it out. If it's not working, the other thing that you can do is actually shoot compressed air in this way. So you're shooting it in this way. You just need to figure out a way to seal this end at the opening of the can, and basically a couple of spurts will shoot that sediment back in this way. You can also use, I believe, a tire pump as well, or like a pump or a compressor to shoot that air back in there. I've seen a couple people do it, but a lot of people just don't have access immediately to that type of equipment. So, you know, compressed air is a little bit better. Just figuring out ways to sort of seal this sort of piece right here and just shoot air in there is what you need to do. Same thing with this opening as well. This one's a more male one. So figuring out, you know, connecting these two ends and then just shooting air into it so that you're dislodging that sediment that's been sitting in there. And you can kind of see this nozzle is a little bit thinner than this nozzle here. This one is really wide, so I don't expect this one to be really clogged up as much. The brands that I've been using are more for the artistic purposes, doing murals and large scale artwork. They're gonna have a thinner sort of nozzle, so you have to really look out or really make sure that you shake up those cans a lot. You know, some of these are, you know, can be $5, $6, $7, $8, $10. You know, some of the specialty ones that come from other countries are $15. So you want to make sure that you don't waste a can. So you really want to make sure you prep it by shaking it up as much as possible. So try that out, and hopefully you had fun seeing me cut open these cans and learning exactly what's inside and sort of like the differences in the mixing balls, because that's, you know, one large mixing ball, and this one, these are two smaller mixing balls for the more artistic spray paint brand. So you're learning exactly how these things work, and that's gonna be great because when you're in the field on a job site actually painting and you run into this problem, you're better able to visualize you know, how that can works, and then you're better able to visualize how to troubleshoot on the fly. So hopefully, like I said, you like the video and you want to comment on it, you want to like it, you want to subscribe, because I want to keep doing these videos. So I definitely need that support. I need that help to grow the channel. So like I said, like, subscribe, share, and I will see you in the next video next week.